getting me back. And what I realized with stuff like this, it's ongoing. It's not like, okay, I'm out of it. You know, there's moments where it's lurking, like, hey, man, remember me? I'm like, fuck, you're still here? So I know a lot of people are dealing with it, and the main thing is consistency. Training helps, of course, and just being outside, just doing stuff to not stay in that dark place.
Hey, Raya, Coach Schaaf and yourself spoke to me earlier this week about how much the game has changed and how people take on different personas and attempt to advance their career. What was the significance of that Be Real t-shirt you wore down to the ring?
Well, that was influenced by Mike Tyson. I don't know if y'all saw that walkout. I mean, that scared me watching it. You know, I didn't play the song because I was like, I don't want to play that song. I don't want to be too scary. But it was just to send a message to be real, man. There's a lot of fake people out there. There's fake people in this room right now. But I love the fact that I can be me. And here's the thing about being yourself. Regardless, you're going to be hated or liked. You know, if you're a piece of shit, be a piece of shit. If you're a good guy, be a good guy. If you're an asshole, kudos. But be your fucking self. So I stay motto to that. And I influence people to be themselves because we all know the world's changing. You can't say shit no more, right? So if I can be me, I can go to bed feeling good about me.
And following the fight, you spoke about wanting to continue this new pursuit of boxing. You made it clear that you want this Jake Paul fight next. If you were to go another direction and that fight weren't to be made, do you want to stay in this boxing realm, maybe fight a former UFC fighter or a different professional boxer?
Honestly, man, I'm just having fun. I mean, you know, again, when I was on vacation, I got this call from my coach. I was like, all right. But I was still in my weird little world of trying to figure out what to do. And plus, I was partially depressed as well. So the training definitely got me out of it, but I'm just having fun. This was a complete different type of setting. The training, of course, wasn't grueling on the body. MMA is hella worse, you know, the getting up and grabbing motherfuckers. This was just pure skill, you know, and technicality, just the hands, the movement, and stuff like that. But yeah, I mean, if the opportunity strikes, I'll definitely do it. Like I said, I love to compete. I'm still in my prime. I still got some more miles on me, and if something comes my way, I'm doing it. But for the most part, I'm just having fun. And yeah, if there's a potential chance to kick that dude's ass, fuck yeah, I'll do it.
Hey, Ryan. Ben Davis from MMA Island. Mixed martial arts, you were known for the kicks. How did you feel your hands were tonight?
You know, there's a weird thing with that. With the moment I put boxing gloves on, I forget about my legs. My legs don't exist. So it was an easy transition. And I can say, as a mixed martial artist, you know, it's like going to grappling class only. You just adjust to it, and going to kickboxing class only. You just adjust to it. And that's what I love about mixed martial arts. You get to pick and take away your weapons and stuff like that. So the adjustment is not a problem at all. Of course, there are moments I'm like, man, I could kick this motherfucker. The open is right there. But, you know, it's good to maintain that discipline. And I saw a lot of holes in my game. I felt it. And it's just getting comfortable in that environment. So I'm excited to go back and train those holes.
Now, after watching Jake Paul go the distance with Anderson Silva, how do you feel a matchup between yourself and him would go? Do you think that you'd find the finish?
Man, this is the part where I gotta be careful what I say, huh? I definitely think I could take him. I mean, he has an awkward style. I was watching him, and his style will lure you in, you know? And it's almost like it's hard to hit him, the way he stands a certain way, and he throws these awkward punches, and almost the fights, from all his fights, he almost does the same thing. But I definitely think I could give him a challenge, because I'll come at him. You know, he'll hit me, but I'll come at him. I don't back up with boxing gloves on. I'll take a couple shots, but I'll come at you. And Le'Veon is probably one of the hardest hitting dudes with those gloves I ever felt. So I don't think Jake hits that hard. Yeah, bro, you don't. Yeah, I said it.
Uriah, I know that you have tremendous respect for Anderson Silva, and he's a beloved figure in combat sports. Watching Jake Paul beat him, does that spark a fire in you?
Do you want to fight him even more? You should have heard me in the background. I was like, revenge is coming. Yeah. But it sucked. It even sucked when I had to fight him. I mean, Anderson has done so much for the sport. He inspired a lot of people, you know, some people in this room. He's an icon, he's a legend. When people say I'm a legend, I'm like, that dude is a legend. And I have so much respect for him. It hurt to watch, but, you know, I gotta separate those emotions, because at the end of the day, it's a skill set. And Jake Paul did what he had to do to win. But yeah, I definitely felt it for Anderson. But to me, he's still one of the greatest of all time, if not the greatest, for being at his age, doing doing what he does, moving the way he does. And I remember when I fought him, I was throwing punches and he would move just enough. And I'm like, I know what the fuck that means. I gotta be careful. So I take nothing away from Anderson. This doesn't even mean anything for what this guy solidified in this game. He's still the best.
And you have the mic in front of you. I don't know if you want to send a specific message to Jake Paul.
You want me to, isn't he here? I can say it to his face. Isn't that better?
Well, he's not here in this room specifically.
Well, when he gets here, y'all tell him that I say, what's up, bro? You know what that means.
What sort of impact do you feel like Jake's victory has had on the sport of boxing? What sort of impact do you feel like Jake's victory has on the sport of boxing? Because obviously he beat a legend of the game, so.
He survived, let's be. I mean, listen, there's a new crowd, right? I'm sure there's more kids out there watching than adults, so the kids love him. What are they, Gen Z, is that what they call them? Yeah, they love him. Millennials, too. They love him. It's good for the sport. It's a good payday. It's entertaining. Listen, the sport is changing. Let's be real here. It's changing. It's entertaining now. It's entertainment. It's not about integrity and honor and all that stuff anymore. It's entertainment. Can you sell? Can you put people in the seats? Can you become a character that we can relate to? Can you say some dumb or weird shit or wear some weird shit or look weird or whatever to put people in the seat? That's what it comes down to. I'm aware of this. I'm not gonna fall victim to that. But if it gravitates those people to come in and pay y'all money, fuck it, do it. I'm here to fuck shit up, get paid, and get the fuck out.
Go ahead. Uriah, did you see anything from Jake's skill set that impressed you at all?
His tattoos. No, I'm kidding. From his, you said his skill set?
Yeah, from what did you see from his boxing today? Was there anything that impressed you from him?
Listen, I'm not here to bash people, man. This sport is hard to do, you know? And even going back to Le'Veon Bell, he took a risk coming in here. I know everybody was like, oh, you're gonna die against Uriah. I'm like, and some people wrote or said, or I should have finished him around. I'm like, this dude is pretty good. He's actually pretty good. So I think Jake is getting better. You know, it's all about consistency. I've watched his first fight to now, and he's actually getting better. But it's all about adjustment. And that's why I like mixed martial arts so much, because you can adjust, but boxing, you can only adjust so much. But honestly, I'm gonna say, I think he's gotten better, but I can see so many holes, and it's just making the right adjustment to, you know, take him out.
Go